Have you ever wondered whatever became of some of the world's most powerful figures' descendants? From Christopher Columbus to Einstein to Stalin? Seldom do we hear about the children, grandchildren, or even great-grandchildren of some of the world's most impactful historic figures. In 1942, Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue, or so goes the popular rhyme of the Genoese navigator. While the poem provides glimpses of Columbus's travel across the Atlantic with three ships from Spain, nothing is said of his wife and children. Columbus was the son of an Italian weaver, but after being shipwrecked off the Portuguese coast, accompanied by his brother Bartholomew, Columbus set up a new life in Lisbon. While there, Columbus tried his luck at mercantile trade, essentially navigating the northern Atlantic waters from Portugal to Iceland to Ireland. It wouldn't be too long before Columbus would take up a new position as an agent working for an Italian firm, Centurioni. The job afforded Columbus the time and comforts of life in Portugal, and by the next year, a courtship with Felipa Perestrello y Moniz, the daughter of an impoverished knight. Columbus made good with Felipa and married her the same year. A year later, their first and only child, a boy, Diego, was born. While Columbus continued in mercantile trade, Felipa remained home with the small son, till in 1485, she fell ill and died. But grief didn't last long for Columbus, as he found delights in the arms of another, Beatriz Enrique de Jarana de Cordoba, the daughter of a peasant farmer. By 1488, Beatriz gave birth to Columbus's second and youngest child, Ferdinand. While on one hand, we can count Columbus's immediate descendants, an Ancestry.com search for anyone sharing the surname Columbus is sure to come up empty. Part of this rests in the theory that Christopher Columbus was never really a Christopher Columbus, nor was he Italian, as he never wrote in the language. Was he Spanish, born on the island of Mallorca, in the Mediterranean then? He never claimed as such, so then perhaps he was Portuguese, or perhaps Catalonian or even German, as far-fetched theorists have speculated. But what we do know is that his real name indeed was not Columbus, but Cristobal Colón. According to Spanish historians, Columbus's own son, Diego, is known to use the surname Colón, and this isn't lost on anyone. Columbus died in 1506, survived only by Beatriz and his two sons, Diego and Ferdinand. The latter Ferdinand, who like his father sailed the oceans blue, and was keen to write a biographical account of his father, never married and had no children. The older Diego, however, had five children, beginning with the oldest, Luis, who's thought to have been born in 1519 or 1520. It's from Diego that 500 years later, descendants still live among us today. In 1992, Cristobal Colón, the 20th direct descendant, attended the 103rd Tournament of Roses Parade, where he stood in front of a painting of his ancestor of the same name. Unfortunately, Colón's attendance sparked controversy as people in a back-and-forth media bonanza questioned his forefather's direct involvement in the slave trade over the Atlantic and the genocide of Native Americans. While the history of Columbus sparks a noteworthy debate of ethics and morality, the history of Einstein of E equals mc-squared fame is nearly universally praised. Born Albert Einstein in 1879, Ulm, Germany, near Bavaria, the acclaimed scientist married twice. First to Mileva Maric, a Serbian he met while studying at the Zurich Polytechnic School. Although they first had a daughter together born in early 1902, not much is known about her, other than speculation that she may have been given up for adoption a year before Einstein and Maric wed. The marriage would produce two sons, Hans Albert in 1904 and Edward in 1910. The latter would suffer from schizophrenia and as a result remained confined to asylums for the rest of his life, never marrying or bearing any children. Marital bliss between Einstein and his wife wouldn't last, and by 1914, both were already living apart, giving way to divorce in 1919. A part of this may be related to Einstein's own infidelity, having started a relationship in 1912 with one Elsa Lowenthal, whom he married in 1920. It is from Hans Albert that Einstein's lineage continues today. In 1927, Hans Albert married Frieda, and together they produced three children. Of the three, only one survived into adulthood. His name was Bernhard Caesar. Not a particularly brilliant student, he did, however, follow in his grandfather's footsteps in becoming an engineer. Living a relatively subdued life, he built his career working for several engineering companies, including Texas Instruments in Dallas, Texas, the maker of some of the most used calculators in schools across the United States. Bernhard passed away in 2008, having fathered with his wife Dora five children. Born 1 year before Einstein in 1878 was Joseph Stalin, considered by one as one of the most impactful figures the world has ever seen. The former Soviet General Secretary, born in a small Georgian town, came to power shortly after the death of his predecessor, Lenin. Under his leadership, through purges of entire ethnic minority groups, forced collectivization, famine, and outright mismanagement, tens upon tens of millions of people perished. More than 20 million alone, historians say, were killed as a result of the purges occurring during his reign from the mid-1920s till his death in 1953. Personally, Stalin could be best described as the Donald Trump of his day. A terrible speaker with no overwhelming talent, except he was skilled in strategy and deceiving people. But the one person who could reach the inner depths of Stalin was his first wife, Ekaterina Svenets, probably the one human being he had really loved, biographer Dmitry Volkogonov once wrote. Svenets married Stalin in 1906 and gave birth to one boy, Yakov, who committed suicide in 1943 while a captive of the Nazi Germany army. An irritant to his father, Yakov's love life was a wreck. His first marriage was to Zoya Gunina, who gave birth to a daughter in 1929. Unfortunately, the first child of Yakov succumbed to pneumonia the same year and died, causing a rift in the marriage between Yakov and Gunina that resulted in both separating. A following relationship with a student of Moscow Aviation School, Olga Golyasheva, resulted in an illegitimate son, Yevgeny, for Yakov in 1936. Yevgeny, who took up residence in Georgia, ardently defended the legacy of his grandfather, suing media outlets that sought to directly blame his grandfather for the murders that occurred during his reign of terror. A politician, Yevgeny helped lead a coalition of communist political parties. Although not yielding considerable power, in 1999, the Stalin bloc for the USSR, as they were known, garnered nearly 500,000 votes in the Duma election in Russia. Yevgeny died in 2016 at the age of 80. Preceded in death by two sons and a younger half-sister, Galina, who passed away nearly a decade before of cancer. Galina, like her brother, openly discredited her family history, speaking against those who spoke of her own father's capture and death in a Nazi prison camp. A brilliant mind, she was an expert philologist who worked as a research assistant at the Institute of World Literature and became a member of the prestigious Writers' Union of Russia. Her marriage to Hussein Ben Saad resulted in a son, Selim, born in 1970. More than 50 years before Selim's birth, Selim's grandfather, Stalin, married a second time, to Nadiza Aluyeva, an Azeri from Baku. The marriage wouldn't last long, as she ended up pulling the trigger on herself in a fit of rage, or so Soviet historians say, in 1932. Aluyeva left behind a husband, two biological children, Vasily 11 and Svetlana 5, and an adopted son. Nadiza's suicide, without saying, deeply affected Vasily. Stalin himself couldn't bring himself to see his own children and instead left Vasily and his sister under the care of a member of the security detail. Young Vasily grew up interested in aviation and attended aviation school, where he met Galina Bonenskaya, whom he married just before he turned 20 years old. So skilled was young Vasily in flying that, after a couple of hiccups that resulted in dropping explosives in the Moskva River and being demoted, he ended up becoming the youngest major general in the Soviet Army at the age of 24. By 1948, he would be promoted twice more, as first as lieutenant general, and then to an Air Force commander. But after his father's death in 1953, Vasily's luck started to turn. Forced to retire from his post, Vasily became entangled in a political scandal that resulted in him being charged with criminal negligence and anti-Soviet propaganda. He would serve nearly 7 years in prison. But by the time he was released, life had taken a toll on Vasily. Vasily died 2 years later at the age of 40. Vasily's sister Svetlana, however, lived nearly another 50 years. 5 years after her brother's death, Svetlana, who had been working in Moscow as a lecturer and a French translator, caused an uproar when she defected from the Soviet Union. She married to Kalikankar Rajput Zamindar, an Indian communist. Svetlana was able to travel to India, and from India was able to apply for asylum at the US Embassy in New Delhi. It wouldn't be for another 10 years in 1978 that Svetlana would gain her American citizenship. And once she did, she quickly moved out of the country, first to England in 1982, and later back to the Soviet Union for 2 years in 1984, before finally moving back to the US. For the rest of her life, whether at press conferences or in tell-all books, Svetlana condemned her father's ruthless leadership, but also acknowledged much of what he did ensured the survival of the country. On November 22, 2011, Svetlana lost her life to cancer, preceded in death by her son, Yosef, and survived by two daughters. So, are you descended from anyone who played a significant role in history? Let us know in the comments section down below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and while you're at it, give us a thumbs up.